a secret. I know a secret.
Long duck dong.
What's happening, hot stuff?
Bowsha.
I can't say it's what I'd have picked for you.
Bowsha's gay.
Nah, he's not gay. He's a sex bomb, dude.
A gay sex bomb.
Oh my god, Bighorn orgy.
Let me in on it, boys.
I don't think they want to let you in on it. What if you could present your cock, and if you were well endowed enough, you would just let in?
Mr. House is like, oh, that's good enough.
Hey, you're the courier that's been stirring things up around here, right?
You're damn right I am.
No, but my boss knows you, and he's very impressed with your work.
In the 40F universe, there's just like 9 different couriers who everybody just thinks is the actual courier, but none of them are.
No, the difference is they're actual like couriers, but for different like companies.
I'll think that they're the courier.
Yeah,
and they're just like, no, I'm
just
a mailman.
There's a very extensive list of all those couriers Mr. House had. They just happen to be every courier but 6.
Smart call.
How's it hanging?
And your
damn
business.
Well, we were well endowed enough to be let in here, so it's hanging pretty good.
I was afraid you wouldn't.
You came.
Name's Michael.
Of course I did.
But please, call me Mike. I know your reputation, and it tells me you're exactly what I need right now. You get the job done, even when the cards are stacked against you. I don't want this traced back to me if the whole thing goes sideways. So before I tell you
anything else,
back.
It'd be blown
I need
to smithereens.
You're willing to take the risk and use discretion.
The risk?
Now, should I continue? Glad to hear it. Now listen closely, pal. Your target is one of the most powerful people on the West Coast. He's the head of an organization which trades in information, always selling to the highest bidder. Now I could try to find whoever's leaking information to him, but that would be only a temporary solution. We need to take out the source. There's a private detective. He's been working with me on this for years. In fact, he's the one who found out the broker was a man. As for payment, how does 800 caps sound?
Make it 1,000.
If that's what it takes. The detective's name is Roy. Mark the location on your map.
You know what was a big letdown?
What?
The Boston Common. You have everybody in the wasteland talking about how there's something dangerous there and everybody who goes there dies.
Oh, and it's just Swan.
And it's just Swan.
It was a big letdown. Fallout 4. Oh.
Oh-ho!
Oh-ho!
Yeah, sure.
Guys,
it was worth it. Did he die?
I don't know. Oh, yep. Well, he did save some powerful people, Ramp. The poor man slipped on the soap, fell perfectly in the bathtub with no clothes on. And
why are you boys following me in here? I don't like this. Yeah, that's right. Leave, okay. Bitch. Okay, cool. Now the top is VIP, UL.
Ultra Lux.
Ultra. Honestly, that probably means Ultra Lux. The Ultra Fuck. Out of the way.
You're out on schedule, courier. Good.
To witness my floating powers.
Oh, he's gone. Dun.
Art is perhaps the only impractical thing I value. And music is the most noble of arts. Listen.
Hey.
I'm listening. I can't move. I can't move my mouse either. But I'm listening. Can you please bring back the man who was floating?
Let's get to business, shall we?
Just pull on the rope.
I believe I should start by saying that Mr. Green will obviously no longer be needing your services. So whatever you thought you had to do here, you don't anymore.
My name? Victor Moriarty, if you really must.
Moriarty?
Although, I doubt that...
It'd be so, like, such a shame if they did a retarded thing like, my cousin in the Capital Wasteland!
You should be more concerned about your ticket.
There's no way.
If they did that, I would just turn it off. Like, no, they ruined it.
We're not doing it. Care of. If that's where the writing goes, you know it's not great.
Personal nature. And if there's anything Green did right, it was hiring you. You demonstrated impressive abilities in the past. And they are the only reason you're still alive.
We think you got spun.
There's a man in the Mojave that goes by the name of Wade. He is a head of a small but effective mercenary organization. He is a complete and utter psychopath. Even outside of his profession, he kills for sport, and he takes his time. By the time he's done with them, the corpses of his victims no longer bear any resemblance to that of human beings. It should be fairly obvious what I need you to do. He lives in an old bunker near Red Rock Canyon. I'll mark the location on your map.
Yet another bunker.
Prepare yourself, because he has an army of mercenaries.
Let me guess, they're all gonna be OP as fuck?
Even admirers with him.
It's just mercs?
Needless to say, absolute discretion.
They're all either gonna have mark.
I don't think so. You know, I'm willing to give this one. I'm gonna give this one the benefit of the doubt.
There is a coin
probably is well more balanced.
With himself.
Well, guess we'll find out.
His first victim.
All right, I'm looking for a hidden.
No!
The Cazador strikes again. Oh, damn.
No, he fucking doesn't.
The anti-Cazador playthrough is just explosives.
I saw you.
There's another one, dude. There's another
yeah,
one.
I know. That's what I'm talking about. I saw you, motherfucker. Alright, Wade Wilson, yep. Let's go.
Classic mod. Yeah.
Who are you? What the fuck do you want?
Wade, I have a message from your bro.
Oh, what does he want now? Hurry the fuck up, I don't have all day. Places to go, people to kill.
Is he a ghoul or is he just...
He's just raspy.
Oh. Raspy.
So it's a package? A present? How lovely. But if he thinks this makes up for his shitty behavior, he's got another thing coming. Still, it's a start. Alright, leave it there and... And why the fuck not? Oh, I see. He got tired of his little brother screwing with his business. That it? I just knew this was gonna happen. You know... I always thought we were too different to be brothers. Come to think of it, Mom was kind of a whore. That sure explains a lot. So, you think you can take me out, huh? Alright, come on in and let the games begin. This ought to be fun. You didn't really think I'd put out right away, did you? No. I'm not that easy. First, you have to prove yourself worthy. And then, we'll have some fun. Just you and me. Like, have you ever met a girl and think to yourself, wow, I could spend my life with her. But then, the other side of you says, I wonder how her head would look on a stick. Or is that just me? Yeah, it is. I can see it from the look on your face. No biggie. We'll work on it. Now, ready for round two?
You're fucking gonna kill Bausha. Bausha just loves licking the top of a Stimpak like it's a lollipop. Yep, there's the combat armor. With each level, they're gonna get more and more bullets, Spongy. The fuck was that scream?
I gotta dance.
I feel like you're just chewing on it.
No.
Come on, dude.
Okay.
Would she hear you licking the fucking Stimpak? What the hell was that? Damn.
They're coming now, though. I know it.
Never saw you come. Oh, what did they have? Shish kebab. Turret in there. Uh-oh. That scream! No!
Oh, I must have made that thing go fucking frenzy.
Damn. Damn. You're lucky.
Bro, I'm gonna need some stims.
And here's my guest of honor. I'm already dressed to kill. I can almost hear the drum roll.
But let's go.
There is just one tiny thing I need you to do before I let you in. There are two prisoners in the room to your right. Be a sweetheart and kill them for me, okay?
Yeah, sure, no problem. Bowsha has no qualms.
He has no fucking moral compass.
No moral compass at all.
I don't want to set the world on fire.
What a brutal way. No?
Good. Very nice. I knew you were a good sport. Now, what are you waiting for? Just one more door.
Not what I was expecting.
Yeah.
Anticlimactic, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Such a bummer. Anyway, I know you've yet to visit the main attraction, but how do you like the show so far? Admit it, you had fun. Killing isn't really as dark and scary as some would want you to believe, is it? Ordinary? You know what? I don't feel like talking anymore. And now I'm gonna kill you.
Jesus Christ, fine.
Back already. To be completely honest, I didn't expect you to survive. But you obviously have a way of exceeding expectations. I assume you have the coin. Well done. It's unfortunate it had to end this way, but he didn't leave me any choice. As promised, here's your reward.
The truth is, I intended to have you eliminated once you've completed the job. But I've been truly impressed by your rather unique set of skills. I could certainly use someone with your expertise. But keep one thing in mind. If you decline my offer, you will be considered a security risk. Good. Because I have another problem I need resolved. It seems one of my informants in the murders has become
overly
greedy. He demands more money.
More
or he will stop providing the information. I would have his handler deal with him, but unfortunately he's otherwise occupied at the moment. Take this. It's evidence of his other activities that the murders wouldn't tolerate. It should give you some leverage. Splendid. The informant's name is Frank. He'll need to hear this passphrase to know you're one of my agents. I miss New Reno, the true den of vice.
God damn! Oh, jackpot! Show me them caps! Show me them caps! I fucking love New Vegas!
Dude, you're just getting chips to play. You're not even playing yet.
This guy's had enough of this, man.
Look at his face. He's just like, fucking Christ.
I can't fucking believe this!
Damn, you're looking tasty.
Hey, big guy. Looking for a good time?
Get out of my way, asshole. Keep your voice down. Where's Henry? I want to talk to him.
Henry is dead.
Yeah, fine. Now where are my caps? You threatening me? You little shit.
Hey, go to bed, asshole. Your ass is getting the injection.
Your ass is gas. Get it?
Are they just looking at pillows?
They're really enjoying those throw pillows.
What the fuck are you looking at?
I would have preferred a slightly different solution for Frank, but what's done is done. Now, are you ready to discuss your Next assignment, there is an organization on the East Coast, known for some of the greatest scientific advances of the post-war era. They've achieved wonders over the years.
We're going to Boston?
Most notable creations are undeniably
synthetic
humans.
Oh! This is not how this was supposed to go!
In a cave to the east, the information is stored in the data module inside the android's head. Sad attempt to make
I love it when there are instructions just in a cave to the east. Like, there isn't like 12 caves.
Yeah. Like, this game doesn't have like a million fucking caves.
Which cave, pray tell?
Resort to violence.
To the east.
Avoid damaging the head at all costs. I cannot stress that enough. The importance.
What if it made you search every mine by fucking searchlight? Good.
Do try and get it done as soon as possible. Time is one of the few luxuries I cannot afford.
Whoa!
Who said whoa? Who said whoa? What was that?
The glowing one yelled whoa! 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 Okay. Whoa!
Whoa, spooky sound.
It's so scary!
Why aren't you disarming the bear traps?
What if I need the monster to run into it?
Good point, good point. Is it getting louder?
Maybe.
That's definitely getting fucking louder.
I see that mine underneath his leg.
Oh my god, I didn't even see that. That's the face of a cool man.
Okay.
Found it.
Oh, it's just a guy. I thought something was gonna like come swimming at me.
Yeah. You got spooked, boy.
What was the point of all that horror music? Just be like, robots.
Look how spooky these iBots are!
That's the scariest thing in here.
That's pretty spooky. Never mind. That's a big fucking cave.
Nope.
How did the robots get past the water?
They swam here.
Yeah!
There we go.
Fuck. Why are there a billion handies down here? Or gutsies?
I guess because the Institute Man left all of them here.
Why did the Institute Man have a billion robots?
I don't know. He took the automatron with him.
He has a robot workbench down here?
Yeah, probably.
Hello, stranger.
Oh, God.
I managed to get past my defenses. The fact that you kept going.
I don't think that's a mark, too.
Less than warm welcome. It tells me you didn't venture here by accident.
This reminds me of that fucking what is it? That mod with the robot girls.
The robot, not the smiley touch
like
robot
angel
race.
Something or
yeah,
something
like that. Although I think this model is from Smiley Tops robot race.
Certain image here of what I'm talking about. Yes.
Did the Institute send him?
Oh god. This was going great. Why did we have
did
to include
I?
Them?
And what would that be? I have a block that prevents me from granting access to the module, or its content, to anyone without the proper authorization. Besides, the module requires special hardware. It's useless to you without it.
Where'd all these robots come
really
from?
Weird.
Here, Don, they'll answer your question.
I have been collecting broken units all across the wasteland.
Okay.
And using spare parts to build.
They put thought into it.
Protection before you came along, but that is not all they were.
But how did they get past the water?
Condemned to a life.
She swam.
It is questionable whether that's a life.
Or there's another entrance that I'm not seeing.
Damn, we're not smart enough.
If I had mintats.
Really, I don't know what to say. Take this.
Nah, that's what you think, sucker.
Oh!
Ooh, this thing's awesome.
That's insane.
This thing kicks ass.
The spooky cave is just probably a, I don't know what to do with this and I want to pad it out.
Damn.
What are the two themes with the spooky cave? You get the spooky cave, go in the water, fight a bunch of robots in a bigger cave.
And then you meet like the nicest robot in the world.
And then you kill her and take the super gun.
Oh, I didn't even notice this beef chunk. Oh, something's happening. I'm gassed.
Oh, no!
I'm gassed.
No!
That's what was spooky. Okay.
Damn. Did we break the sequence and make it to her before?
I wanted to look at the fucking meat.
I hope you didn't.
I didn't.
You guessed me?
Why? I'm delivering it to you.
I couldn't risk putting myself in an inferior position by letting you have a bargaining chip.
Damn, he hung up that meat just so that way we would look at it.
I had someone follow you and relieve you of it as soon as possible. I trusted their fear of me to keep them from doing something reckless. You, on the other hand, are too fearless, too unpredictable to be entrusted with an object of such importance. However, you did fulfill your end of the bargain, and now I'm going to fulfill mine. Here's your compensation. I was testing you. A test of both your abilities and your willingness to do what's necessary. And you did not disappoint. Before you go, there is one thing I need you to know with absolute certainty. Wherever you go, whatever you do, to whomever you talk, I'll know.
Quark.
I'll always be keeping my eye on you. Good. Now I believe we're done here. It's been a pleasure.
The secret.